How to write the discussion section of a research paper. Hello, my name is Antony P from the University English Hub, and here are my super clear steps on how to write your discussion section with examples. Keep watching until the end of the video to learn what not to put in your discussion section. The discussion section is your chance to explore the importance and relevance of your results. The key focuses of a discussion section include a summary of your key results, an interpretation of what those results can mean, an investigation into potential implications of the results, like why they matter, an exploration of the limitations of the results, and finally, your discussion section includes recommendations for future research. Let's jump into the steps on how to write. Step one, state your key findings. In about one paragraph, restate your research problem and summarize core findings in a clear statement that answers your research question. For example, in this study, we investigated the impact of social media usage on academic performance among university students. Our findings reveal a significant negative correlation between the time spent on social media and students' academic performance, suggesting that increased social media usage is associated with lower grades. Step two, give your interpretations of your findings. Write about how your findings exactly answer your research question. This may be obvious to you, but may not be obvious to an international audience. You can identify correlations and patterns in the data. You can discuss if the results supported your hypotheses or not. Then compare and contrast your findings to the other research on the topic. Consider explaining how your results fit into the larger web of research. Then discuss any unexpected results and write about where you believe these unexpected results might have come from. Here's an example sentence. Our findings align with previous research, including a detrimental effect of excess social media use on academic outcomes. Contrary to our initial hypothesis, which predicted a moderate negative correlation, our results demonstrated a stronger association between social media use and academic performance. This discrepancy may stem from the diverse demographics of our sample compared to previous studies, as well as the evolving nature of social media patterns. Step three, discuss the implications of your research. How do your findings fit within the existing knowledge, and what new insights do your findings contribute? Are there any consequences to an industry profession because of your research? If your findings challenge existing theories, explain why. Example sentences. By highlighting the detrimental impact of excessive social media use on academic performance, our study underscores the importance of promoting responsible digital habits among students. These findings carry significant implications for educational institutions, policymakers, and parents, emphasizing the need for comprehensive strategies to mitigate the negative effects of social media on learning outcomes. Furthermore, our research contributes to the ongoing discourse surrounding technology's influence on academic achievement, challenging existing assumptions and promoting further investigation into the complex dynamics of digital engagement in educational settings. Step four, acknowledge the limitations of your research. Even the most robust studies have holes or room for improvement. Common research limitations include small sample sizes, short observation length, and confounding variables. Write about the weaknesses in your research design so that other researchers can make improvements on your design. Here's an example. Despite the valuable insights gained from our study, several limitations warrant consideration. Firstly, the reliance on self-reported data may introduce bias and inaccuracies. Additionally, the cross-sectional design limits our ability to establish causality between social media use and academic performance. Further research employing longitudinal methods and objective measures of digital activity could provide a more nuanced understanding of these relationships. Furthermore, the homogeneity of our sample, comprised primarily of undergraduate students from a single institution, may restrict the generalizability of our findings to broader populations. Step five, share your recommendations. Your findings may impact a profession or an industry, and this is your chance to dive into those potentialities. Perhaps your findings found an efficiency gain that an engineering company should consider, or perhaps your findings found a major flaw in past research that will encourage future studies. Here's an example. In light of our findings, we recommend educational stakeholders implement targeted interventions that promote digital literacy and mindful technology use among students. Educational institutions should consider integrating curriculum-based initiatives aimed at fostering responsible social media habits and time management skills. Furthermore, collaboration between educators, parents, and technology developers is essential to create supportive environments that prioritize success while acknowledging the role of technology in students' lives. By addressing these recommendations, we can mitigate the adverse effects of social media on academic performance and cultivate more conducive learning environment for future generations. Now, let's talk about what not to put in your discussion section. Don't include new results. You should only discuss the data that is reported in the results section. Don't make wild claims. Be realistic about what your data shows. Don't underestimate your research. The discussion of limitations should aim to strengthen your credibility. Now you are a discussion section master. Good luck writing your research paper. If you have any questions, leave them below the like button and I will read them and reply. My name is Antony P. from the University English Hub. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in another video. Bye!